Hi friends, this is Sarvajan here. Welcome to my networking channel. Hope all are doing good. And today let us debug VRRP authentication issues. So this is an architecture where I connected R1, ESW1 and ESW2. So what is VRRP? VRRP is a standard base, right? So what we call as a virtual router redundancy protocol. So VRRP, in case of VRRP, primary is we call it as a master and secondary is called as a backup router, right? So this is an architecture where ES1 I configured as a master router and ESW2 is a backup router. So this IP is 10.2 and 10.3 and the virtual IP is 10.1, right? So to this I have connected another router switch and to this I have connected PC1 and PC2. So both are in the same VLAN. VLAN 10 I have created. So both are in the same VLAN. This is 10.4 and 10.5. So this is a router. So this is the outgoing interface. So today what happened, due to some authentication issues, what happened, I'm not able to reach from PC1 to this corresponding interface. I'm not able to reach this 1.1 and 1.2. And from this PC2, I'm not able to reach the corresponding outgoing interface. So we need to just go debug the issues, VRRP authentication issues. So now let us go to the individual router. Before going into the architecture, I'm going to show the configuration, what are things I have done. So go to ESW1. So I configured show run interface VLAN 10. So this is the thing I configured, VLAN 10. And we have to configure the IP address followed by the VRRP group number IP. Then I have created this is a priority 200 because this will be elected as a master router. So this is elected by the router with the highest priority. So this is elected as a master, right? It's because of the highest priority, and this is should be elected as a backup. So here I'm seeing some issues. I'm seeing some bad authentication from 10.3, this particular ESW2. So now let us check show VRRP brief. So this is elected as a master, I told. So this should be elected as a backup, right? So go to ESW2 and let us see show VRRP brief. So this is also elected as a master. Why? Because of the VRRP authentication issues. So why? Because since by the authentication, there is an authentication mismatch between ESW1 and ESW2. So both are elected as a master router. So that is the issue. So now we need to go and fix the issue. So let us go to ESW3 show run interface VLAN 10. So this I configured 10.6. So this is a 10.6 IP. So this I have not configured the VRRP. Only these two I configured the VRRP. And due to the authentication mismatch error, I'm seeing the bad authentication error from ESW2, right? So we need to fix the issue. So let us go to corresponding VLAN interface, show run interface VLAN 10, and let us also check from ESW2, show run interface VLAN 10, right? So you can compare it, comparatively you can check it out. So this we have configured the authentication parameter, and here there is no authentication. So that is the reason for the authentication mismatch. So I want to check from PC1 to PC2 whether I'm able to reach this PC, and let us now check this corresponding interface. So let us go to PC1. So I configure this interface 10.4. So let us ping the PC2 IP 192.168.10.5. So I'm able to ping from PC1 to PC2. Let us ping from PC2 to PC1. So this also I'm able to ping. So now let I'm going to ping this corresponding interface 1.1 and 2.1. So let us ping 1.1. So ping 192.168.1.1. So I'm seeing the timeout error. Why? Because due to an authentication mismatch, what happened? Both the primary and the secondary router are elected as a master router. So we need to go and fix that issue. So let us ping from PC2 also. So ping 192.168.2.1. So this also I'm not able to ping, right? So 2.1 and 2.2 I'm not able to reach from PC2 to this corresponding outgoing interface and PC1 to this corresponding interface due to an authentication mismatch error. So now let us fix the issue. So before that, what are things I have done is, so this I have configured the directly connected interfaces and all these routers I have configured the routing protocol EAGRP. So all this router I have configured the routing protocol EAGRP for the communications. So since we are different networks, there should be a communication between all these routers and switches. So that's the reason I configured the EAGRP. So now let us fix the authentication issue. Show run interface VLAN 10. So what here I configured as hello, and here we are not configured any authentication parameter. So let us fix it out. VLAN 10. So go to the configuration mode, interface VLAN 10. How to configure VRRP followed by the group number, authentication, hello, right? So this is the authentication we have to configure. Same authentication I have done. So now let us see. So now immediately, previously what is the situation is master, even the secondary is elected as a master because of the authentication mismatch error. So after configuring both, now this is elected as a master because of the highest priority. So this is now elected as a backup router, right? So now let us see. Show VRRP brief. So this is elected as a master. And now let us take it from ESW to show VRRP brief. So now this has been elected as a backup router. So now the situation is normal. So now we have to reach from this corresponding IP to this 1.2 and this corresponding outgoing interface. So let us now check it out. So PC, yeah, so now I'm able to reach from PC1 to this corresponding interface 1.1. I'm able to reach, let us reach 1.2. Yeah, so the 1.2 also I'm able to reach. So only because of the authentication mismatch. So now let us reach from 2.1 and 2.2. Go to ESW2. So 2.1 I'm able to reach, and let us also reach 2.2, right? And also another thing I want to show you. So since this is selected as a master, let us see the traffic flow from PC1 to 1.2. How to check it out? Go to PC1, do a trace. Trace 192.168.1.2 minus P, we have to do 6. Why? Because protocol I'm doing is TCP. So you're able to see, right? It is how the traffic is going via 10.2 only because master is elected as a, this is elected as a master. So this is elected as a backup. So this always traffic will go via master to reach this corresponding interface. So let us check from PC2. Go to PC2 and let us check it out. So let us do a trace. So trace 192.168.1.2 minus P6. So it is going via 10.2, right? So this is the way it will work. So if you want, let us do a trace to 2.2, how it is going. So you're able to see, right, even the 2.2, the corresponding interface, it is going via this because this is elected as a master. So this traffic will not be utilized. Only the primary will be utilized. So the traffic go via 10.2, then 10.3, and then for simultaneously it will go for 2.2. So now you are able to see how to debug the VRRP authentication issue. So always the primary is elected as a master and the second is elected as a backup router. So this is the way we can debug and fix the authentication issue. So VRRP is a standard base, HSRP is a Cisco proprietary. That is the only difference. So I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos. Thanks and have a wonderful day. Thank you.